Hello, thank you for watching this video. In this abstract video, we will introduce our temporary method and briefly discuss its theory background. The CDR method has been widely used in the determination of fibrous structures. The object of our interest is illuminated by a highly coherent plane wave, and the diffraction patterns are recorded by a CCD detector. The detector can only measure the intensity of the diffraction. By using an iterative algorithm, the spatial phases can be retrieved, and therefore we can reconstruct the projection image of the object. However, in the reality, the noise does exist, and usually impairs the image quality. Then how to enhance the image quality becomes a challenging problem. A rule of thumb of the heavy atom method indicates that the best case is to have about similar intensity contribution from the heavy atoms and the light atoms. However, we will show that the concept that uses heavy atoms can enhance the image quality of non-crystalline biological samples in the CDI microscopy. That is, in our case, the intensity contribution from the heavy atoms will be much larger than that from the sample of our interest. This is our template. In our demonstration, we use the mimivirus as a biosample. The mimivirus is as shown located near the goal object. But we also consider the case that the virus is overlapping with the object. The diffraction intensity measured by the detector can be formulated as I of k, where A equals to F plus G, where F is the Fourier transform of the template, and G is the Fourier transform of the biosample. Beta is a constant determined by the experimental parameters. In particular, beta is proportional to the photon flux and exposure time of the light beam. We should also take the noise contribution into consideration. So actually, we are measuring A prime of k, which includes an additional term, n of k. Here, we will not show the mathematical analysis. In the paper, we will show that the level of capital N approximates to the inverse of square root of beta. This result is counterintuitive, since the contribution of Poisson noise to the diffraction amplitude is only dependent on the experimental settings. We consider Poisson noise and the beat stop at the center of the detector. We use an iterative algorithm called GHIO to reconstruct the image. After GHIO iterations, we can get the reconstructed images. If we only measure the mimivirus without using the template, the image quality is not so good. Now we put the mimivirus within the template. As you can see, the image quality is greatly improved. Now we change the thickness of the template, which means that we are changing the total charge ratio of the heavy atoms to light atoms. When the total charge ratio becomes very large, the error converges to a certain level, confirming what we have presented in the theory analysis. To summarize, we show a counterintuitive result that when adding heavy atoms, the error contributed from Poisson noise is independent of the sample property. In addition, when using the template, the convergence rate is greatly enhanced in the reconstruction algorithm. Thank you for your attention.